Hi, I'm Nadia Summers. I'm a student at Iowa State. I study music education. I play French horn. I'm from Atlantic, Iowa, which is about 2 hours away from Ames. And I'm a student employee at Parks Library, and I've been asked to just kind of share some of my thoughts about COVID-19 and how it's just been affecting me as a student, and yeah. I think when it all really hit me though was on March 18th, a day that I will always remember. It was when we got the email saying that we were going to be going online for the rest of the semester, and they were requesting that we move out of the dorms and say bye to campus until hopefully next fall. Hopefully we're back by then. And that hit me hard, just like I'm sure it hit a lot of other people. I'm a junior, so I'm super thankful that I will be able to come back and I have another year. So yeah, that was just a bummer to hear, and especially as a music major where quite a few of my classes are just, you have to be there to really do it. Band, orchestra, conducting, you know, these are things where you have to be there, and you have to have the feedback from professors. I have classes where we do peer teachings, and how do you do a peer teaching when your peers are not here with you? So there's that, and I was gonna be doing my practicum over spring break, which was last week, and that got canceled, and all practicums for the rest of the semester are canceled likewise. So at some point I'll have to find 24 hours to make up that whole experience, and I'm not sure how that's gonna work yet, but we're waiting, and that's all we can do right now is wait. So that's that, I guess. Other things, classes, activities. Still, thank God for technology, guys. Like, that's all I have to say about that, because we've got FaceTime now, Skype, WebEx and Zoom, and just all these platforms that we can still stay in contact with our peers and our teachers that make this online learning thing possible. And that's really great. It's not ideal, but we're still having the opportunity to further our education and keep learning. And from a social standpoint, you know, who wants to leave campus and be away from their friends for 5 months until August? No one. At least I doubt anyone does. So it's really great to be able to have the technology to still be in contact and see their faces, hear their voices, and even though we aren't there in person, it's really nice, really encouraging to just still have that available and have that support. I am an introvert, hardcore. I love my friends, I love my family, I love being around them, but I need my alone time. So honestly, it hasn't been too hard. I'm keeping busy as much as I can with school and practicing and crafts, reading, just fun things. But even as someone who enjoys their alone time, it's been kind of difficult. Just knowing that even if I wanted to go out, it's not really a safe option right now. And it's just nice to have that choice. Like, if I want to go out and go hammocking with my friends, or if I want to go play a board game, it's nice to have that option. So that's something that's difficult about this. And I can only pray for the extroverts of the world who are people and need to get out and have that interaction, and they thrive off of that. So I'm sorry to all of you. I hope you can find some sort of peace in your self-quarantine. just try to make the best of it, honestly, because something my mom keeps saying, and I agree with, is that I think it's good in a way that this is happening. Obviously, it's not good that people are getting sick and dying, but I think it's good for the world to just slow down, even if it's only for a few weeks. Maybe, though, it'll drag on for months, who knows, but I think it's a good thing. And we all get so busy, so caught up in work and school and being social and all these things. They're good things, but they can distract us, I think, from things that are more important. So Avery is a guy I went to high school with in Atlantic, and he also goes to Iowa State. You're a freshman?
Yeah, I'm a freshman.
Yeah, so how has it affected you and like your studies, and how's it going?
Well, I mean, it's a lot different than going to college. I kind of came to college just for the whole, you know, being in college up at a university experience. And now with COVID-19, that's just gone like that. So personally, I'm obviously not a fan of it. I will say I am lucky to have a parent that works from home full time, so she at least gave me some decent advice, like, you know, try to keep a regular schedule. And but yeah, other than that, it's just, I'm just not a huge fan, and I can't wait to get back to Iowa State in the fall. So
I feel that. So here I am in Friley, it's the dorm that I've lived in for 2 years, moving out mid-March, I mean. We can see that they've finally replaced the stairs. They've like been under construction all year, so got it done in time for us to move out, I guess. And here we go, going into my dorm room. And here it is, our cute little things, and the room. My roommates all moved out. There's my mom. Wave, mom. Say hi.
Hi. Yep. Helping to move out.
Yep. That's it. I feel like move out day is always kind of a sad thing, regardless of whether it's due to COVID-19 or something else. So just like the end of the year, I guess, is the something else. But yeah, so it was kind of like a melancholy day, and the skies were all gloomy, and it was kind of drizzly, so like, lame. It's super pretty right now, though. I'm at Atlantic's quarry, and I'll like show you. It's, look at the sky, it's so pretty. And then the lake, there's a whole bunch of other lakes too. It's so nice. I love this place. Really not a bad place to be in quarantine. So the day got better. But moving out's just work, tiring, kind of sad. But there's a bright spot. I got to go to music hall once more for the semester and turn in my wind ensemble folder. Saw Dr. Glimo and a couple other professors and just some friends. It was really good to see them, since might not see them for like 5 more months in person, who knows. But it was good to see them and just know that everyone's doing okay, everyone's staying safe and 6 feet away and all that, so it's good. Here we are out at, we call it the other place, It's land owned by my grandparents, and we're trying to birdwatch. Maybe not having the most success, but we can hear them. So that's exciting. Quarantine things. American flag and all these cars all the way down Main Street honking and waving and just having a good time cruising.
To this extent, and we did drag Maine. It was a two-way street then. It went to a one-way street and then back to a two-way street. But it was a lot of fun back then, and and tonight is pretty bizarre. Brings back a lot of memories.
Yeah, I bet.
So I had to get out and check it out and see what it was going to be like, and it was a good time. So I really support the town of Atlantic for putting this on, and they're going to continue to do it, I think, from every Thursday night. And
it's awesome.
Kind of cool. So. Mm-hmm.